That's right. Just as like a coffee filter, we all listen to everyone through a filter. And the filter is comprised of our ABCs. And our ABC stands for our attitudes, beliefs, and culture. So when you're listening to someone, be mindful of your ABCs, attitude, belief, and culture, and be aware of their ABCs as well. For more thoughts, you can visit me, ericpap.com. You can also download my app, Eric Papp. Thanks a lot, and this is your life.
Ba ba bum. You gotta love computers. It is the world famous Jiggy Jaguar show. Yes, indeed.
Jiggy Jaguar.
We are back here on the big broadcast. Check us out at jiggyjaguar.com, coast to coast and motor to motor. We've got Jay Gutierrez with us today. He spent 20 years in the Air Force and Army as an F-16 jet engine mechanic and a helicopter engine and airframe mechanic. He has received many awards and has plenty of stories to tell us today. And we wanted to get Jay on to talk about Nighthawk Minerals. You guys are doing some amazing stuff over there with this. I know that it's a anti-aging is kind of what I want to talk about today in regards to Nighthawk Minerals. Sure. Talk to us a little bit about how Nighthawk Minerals can help with the anti-aging aspect.
You know what? I'm glad someone asked about that finally. We've been doing this for quite a while. We work, for anybody who doesn't know, we mine stones out of Wyoming and Utah that are naturally radioactive and have for years, naturally out of the ground like that. And we've been helping people with degenerative disease such as cancer, MS, many things over the years. And we have our own doctors, nuclear physicists, you name it. And what we realized is, after all these years, we're very successful and helped save a lot of lives. But we were able to, because I am an old mechanic, I had to see things work or I don't believe it. And I wasn't seeing what they were called, the modality called radiation hormesis.
Yes.
Which is a theory that a little bit of radiation is good for you. In other words, they're saying as the radiation goes through you, it slightly damages or stresses your cells and DNA. And when that happens, it triggers your immune system. Well, we all these miracles we've witnessed over the years, people seeing again, walking again, all kinds of things. But I wasn't seeing that theory there. I had a hard time matching it up every time. And the way things work, we were able to validate finally that it never was the radiation helping our people. It was the frequencies.
Yeah.
And so what we did, actually we found out by, which will go back to your anti-aging, when we first started out understanding it was frequencies, what we did is we put stones inside cattle tanks.
Okay.
To keep the algae off.
Yeah.
And what would happen is not only did they get rid of the algae, they would produce acid, but the pHs in the waters were better than they were getting out of their wells.
Okay.
And so the cattle were drinking healthier water than them. But what we realized with these frequencies, there's only two ways to change the pH in water, and that's chemically or with frequencies. And when these frequencies bring the pHs back in like that, anything that's causing acid or decay is in an environment it can't exist.
Okay.
So, in other words, I'll give you an example. We had a lady here when we used to take people here. We did for years, but now we work with most people on the phone.
Okay.
But this lady came here, and she had four-stage big open breast cancer, four-stage lung cancer, and brain cancer, 48 years old. And we kept her here for 9 weeks, and we put her in waters. Waters are carriers of frequencies, okay?
Okay.
And we'd submerge her open cancer inside these waters. Well, those frequencies bringing in the pH, we watched that tumor just die in front of us.
Wow.
All right? And what happened was, because of the frequencies, over the 9 weeks she was here, she was, with all that cancer, she was taking college courses. Her frequencies in her body were so high, and her clarity was so high. Number one, she was pulling straight A's on her college, and also she was doing her husband's homework and getting straight A's. Her thinking was just so clear. But What we also saw when she did in these tubs 2 times a day is she got younger, and it all made sense why. Okay, because we were repairing and stopping the acid and from forming in the body and with her cancer. So she's back in Denver now. She's cancer free. But I mean, these are things that aren't theory. We see them.
We've got Jay Gutierrez with us today here in the big broadcast, talking Nighthawk Minerals, also talking anti-aging with us today. Anti-aging is a big topic these days. It is a tremendous, you know, everybody and their brother wants to not grow old. That's pretty much how it comes down. And Jay Gutierrez recently was quoted as saying, when we work at saving lives using radiation homesis, one of the typical responses we see from the person is, for lack of saying it in another way, they seem to get younger. Even myself, if you had seen me just 5 years ago and looked at me now, you would not recognize me at first. I'll be 50 next month, going on 40. Tell us about how Nighthawk Minerals and all this works with the anti-aging situation.
Well, you know, the anti-aging just happened to be a bonus, along with many other things. In fact, you know, believe it or not, I've had people in positions high above yours and mine come out to visit me. And I live in a ghost town in southeast Colorado. We get doctors and scientists from all over the world, from Korea, Africa, you name it, they come here. And some of these bigger guys have come out here to see me, and it wasn't looking for, you know, helping people overcome cancer. These are guys with a lot of money that were looking for anti-aging. Now, they were correct. In other words, what I always find fascinating is if you look in your history, you took in class Ponce de Leon, okay, and you still see it all over the place. He was looking for the fountain of youth, okay, and everybody laughs about that. In actuality, he was correct. Once you have the correct frequencies from whatever, that, like let's say we work with, if there was water near to carry and you bathed in it, that is a fountain of youth.
Really? Break that down for me a little bit more.
Okay. Well, like I say, Ponce de Leon, like I say, when he was looking for the fountain of youth, it's just like what we do here. In our tubs, when we have people come out here, or we even have them do it at home, we load tubs up with water and stones, which create the frequencies, okay? They're the carriers of the frequencies, which restructures the water. It's called restructuring waters. Now, when you're restructuring water, what it is water molecules have a memory. And when you imprint a frequency on a water molecule, it spreads to other water molecules, and that's how you restructure water. So when we put these people into these waters with whatever degenerative disease we're working with, right, they're bringing in all these frequencies that are bringing the pH in. Not only that, they're doing many other things. As a matter of fact, we've taken these frequencies out here and put them on these large pivot units for irrigation. And not only did we use half the water and get all the more growth we need to use in these same frequencies, but it actually even helped change the weather. It was pretty incredible. But I could take these people out there. It's like a man came here. He had cancer in his mouth. Well, we helped him get rid of it. It was a tough one, but he came out here and wanted to visit us for helping him. So I took him out there into the fields, and I told him, I says, you see all this green here? You see all this beautiful? Those are because we were able to do it with the agriculture. I said, those are the same frequencies that fix the cancer in your mouth. So, but
I am just
we're just scratching the surface.
We've got Jay Gutierrez with us today here on the big broadcast. Nighthawk Minerals is the topic. We're also talking anti-aging today here on the program. And I also want to chat with Jay here about some other things that are going on. We were talking there about low-dose radiation helping to heal people. Past 20 years or so, you've been providing hope, help, and healing for people with numerous varied physical conditions. Talk to me about this.
Well, we've been doing this for actually getting close to 30 now. I started out close to 30 years ago doing an Army mission up in northern Wyoming. Had a helicopter go down, had a fuel problem. And I found some stone on the ground, and I was drawn to it. It was a green and blue, and I knew a lot about turquoise, but this was a chrysocolla, they call it. And after a year's time, I was able to go back and mine it, and I figured it was a stone I was drawn to. I'd make some jewelry. Well, I made jewelry, and I was fixing helicopters at the same time, too. But people started getting better from all kinds of things. And see, and I'm not really holistic or metaphysical myself. Like I say, if you're up in the air, I got to know how you're staying up there. But the thing is, once I saw these people getting better, we took the stones to the labs, had them break it down, found out there was a radioactive element to it, took it to Rocky Flats Arsenal, had my guys out there check it. Guy says, yes, Jay, the stuff's slightly radioactive. Right then and there, I thought, because the way we've been conditioned, I was killing people. You know, I mean, I was scared. I was going to call people up, buy necklaces back, and all kinds of things. But actually finding out, though, that this was actually real. In fact, in this country, in the 1910s, 20s, 30s, and 40s, we used to use natural radiation to help people heal with great success. Then we had Nagasaki, Hiroshima, and everybody became radiophobic, and we're just conditioned. You hear radiation, you run the other way, and you don't even know why. But see, now here's what we did. We used the backing of radiation hormesis for years because it's all we had. But we were able to validate straight up that it was frequencies working with people. And after we learned that, the way we've been approaching all these different problems that mankind's having, from degenerative diseases to soils, we've been using these same frequencies, and they've been fixing it. In other words, it's like my doctors, we've taken out the people we've worked with over the years and realized over the years, first of all, this will only work with the truth, okay? Second of all, over the years, we've noticed these frequencies have never done the wrong thing. They've always done the right thing. They've always overpowered the bad frequencies. We've proved it with honeybees and all kinds of things. My doctors call it these frequencies. He calls it God's breath. You know, and from as far as I'm concerned, they are. But like I say, they don't know how to do the right thing. So by using this and understanding that it works off of not black and white, but right or wrong. Working with the farmers, working with the ranchers, working with the beekeepers, working with oncologists, scientists. We've been seeing all kinds of results out here. But we're very responsible with it and make sure people understand what they're doing, especially if you call up here with a degenerative disease. I want to make sure you understand everything that's going on, why and what's going on, so you get the support you need. And, well, that just happens to be one of those things. Once you've stopped decay,
yeah.
Anything producing acid, you've done
your. We've got a great guest with us today. Jay Gutierrez joins us. Nighthawk Minerals is a tremendous, tremendous company. Nighthawkminerals.com is their official website. Nighthawkminerals.com. And Nighthawk Minerals, you guys are doing some amazing stuff with this over there. Explain to me good radiation versus bad radiation.
All right. Now, like I told you before, we found a frequency that's a true frequency, okay? It always does the right thing. And it was naturally out of the ground like that. Well, here's what happened is then man took it, and what did we do? Let's take low-grade uranium ore, okay? What did we do? We took it, and we spun it. We enriched it. We altered it, okay? So what did you do? You took a truth, and you made it an untruth to where it's only there to destroy. All right? So those are the main differences between man-made radiation and natural radiation. Natural radiation, you know, the correct life-giving frequency is one that destroys and repairs, and that's what we're seeing here and have been for years.
Okay, kind of delve into that a little bit more for our listeners here.
Well, you know, what I'm seeing here. Now I never really was into frequency medicine and things like that. And I, cause I have to see it to believe it, but the more I'm seeing here, like with soils, okay, let's take soils. All right. I've got a guy out here with a big irrigation system, and through the years of pesticides and fertilizers, they've got a compaction on the earth, on the soils that Mother Nature just having a good time trying to bust through with floods and hail all over the country. But we realized once we brought in and broke the compaction up and brought in those frequencies into the soil using irrigation, the whole place greened up. We didn't have any hail, flooding, and it was just setting things right. In other words, these frequencies, and if you go through history, by the way, okay, this isn't new. This has been through history. Look up the works of actually a man I didn't even care for his work, but it was Wilhelm Reich. He was in the 1920s. Okay, he was pushing what they called Oregon energy and cloud busting. Well, everybody's been trying to validate it. Well, we did it here without even realizing it. And so it's not even theory anymore. We know what's going on and it's working. That's how all my people are getting better.
It is Jay Gutierrez with us today here on the big broadcast. You can get more information at Nighthawk Minerals online at nighthawkminerals.com. And Jay has been doing all sorts of different things for all the years here. Would this be considered alternative medicine, or what exactly would Nighthawk Minerals be considered?
Well, you know, what we do is alternative medicine, okay. But we work hand in hand with our own medical doctors, okay. We're the only ones in the world that do this. Very successful, been for years, but we're a small group of people. So we do, you know, we do radio, and word of mouth is mostly it. But what we do is when people call here, let's say you've got leukemia, okay? You call here, you've got leukemia. Because remember, our number one, even though we help with agriculture and stuff, our number one goal is always to be able to support and help people. Okay, that's come, always has to come first. So you called up here with leukemia, and I already know what it is, by the way. So what I'm going to do, though, I'm going to put you on what we call the three divine protocol. God put it together. Okay, number one is frequencies, to where you'd call me up. I'd be your wellness instructor. I'll be putting stones on different areas of your body that we mine and cut ourselves. We go about a mile underneath the ground and mine them and cut them ourselves and measure them out. We know what's working with people.
Well, Jay, kind of explain to me here the situation with how what you guys do. As far as Nighthawk Minerals, you guys are doing some amazing stuff. I know that we were talking a little bit there. We don't have I lost track of time here. We don't have a lot of time left on the clock here. But kind of condense what you were getting ready to say here. Give us a quick soundbite because we've got to run along because we've got our good friend Dr. Jack Chiarovella going to be calling us here in a few moments. And I don't want you guys running into each other. It's not that there's any issues. I want to keep everybody on the same even keel. So go ahead and jump in there. I'll sit back and I'll listen. Jump in there, Jay.
Okay. Well, normally what we do, and just run over this, but we've been working with our people. Number one is frequencies on the three divine protocol. That's what we're putting on your stones. I'm watching for die-off and acclimation, people that are energy sensitive, and that can go into further discussion too. But then we also, by the time people get to us, their immune systems are usually compromised. They are. So we build them up with our people out of Alabama, Water Divine. We put them on angstrom-sized minerals for 10 days, magnesium, calcium, potassium, zinc, trace minerals, and vitamins. I run them out for 10 days. We're getting better. And by that time, we'll switch over to a cleanse using minerals, silver and copper, clean out the bile ducts and the lymph system so I can get the poisons to eliminate from the body. And we'll show you how to, ways to do that, too. And then the third part is parasite identification and elimination. And when it comes to my people's lives on the line with the third part of the three divine, I don't want muscle testing, kinesiology, or a biofact feedback machine. When it comes to parasite testing, I want my medical doctor looking at your stool sample underneath his dark field microscope and telling us exactly what eggs he's seeing. And then I wanted a natural remedy target for that parasite or parasites. And that's how we do it.
Well, you're doing some amazing stuff over there. Before we let you go, I have a little question here before we go to break. How do we get a hold of you guys besides NighthawkMinerals.com? Is there a Twitter or Facebook or anything? Do you guys do social media?
We have a toll-free number, and it's 888-563-8389.
Yeah.
And we have people there, even myself, I work with our people. I love working with our people because, you know, how could you not?
Well, I'll tell you, Jay, we got some stuff coming down, and I'm going to let you go, my friend. And we will we will talk to you. It is getting interesting here in the studio. So, Jay, I will let you go, and we will talk to you very soon. Thanks for being on with us today, brother. Appreciate it.
Blessings to you, my friend. Thank you for having me on.
Definitely. Talk to you soon, man. Later. It is Jay Gutierrez here on the big broadcast, known the world over as the world-famous Jiggy Jaguar Show. We're going to take a quick time out here. Frank Savalto, from the New Media Journal, also my good, close, personal, longtime friend, Mr. Dr. Jack Caravelli, will be with us to talk about the situations overseas and also the lone nut, as they say, who did the Navy shipyard thing. If you're watching us on Starcom Media Television,